Happy homecoming. This is your broadcast for September 21st. Roll the intro. Western Wednesday was a success with both the first and second lunches full of horseshoe tossing, quick draw competitions. The first of the winner of the first lunch competition was the Elpers, and the seniors took a win for a second lunch.
In the beginning, we had to do a horseshoe toss from three different distances and see whoever can get them the closest. Ended up being the freshmen and the seniors. It was a tie, so we had to do a standoff. Then I took that dub because I shot him, you know. It looks great, bro. 219, we're going to take that dub. The Spirit Bowl, you already know. We got the most spirit points. We getting that W.
Congrats on getting Wild West. There's a banned book week every school year to highlight books that are seen as controversial.
My name is Kara Budge, and I am the librarian here at West. Banned Books Week is an event, it's annual, and it celebrates our freedom to read, and it highlights intellectual freedom and avoiding censorship, and anytime a book is challenged, then it kind of is highlighted, and usually because of the efforts of teachers and librarians and students that are committed to intellectual freedom, those books remain on our shelves. It started in the 1980s, and it was a librarian who had seen all these challenges coming to pass and wanted to protect our First Amendment rights and keep books on the shelves that were being censored. And so it's when it started, and now they celebrate it annually to just bring attention to this. This last year, the most banned books were some that you can find in our library. 13 Reasons Why was the most challenged book last year. George was another book that was challenged. The Hate U Give and To Kill a Mockingbird is always continuously challenged. I just recently read The Hate U Give, and it's a great one. It's coming out in a movie soon, and it highlights a lot of the issues of the Black Lives Matter. And I've read all of them, actually, and they're all great, but I do love that one.
Go to the library this week to check some banned books out. Didn't know who the Teacher of the Year was? Well, let's see who it is.
Hi, West. I'm Kelly May, and I was a teacher here last year, and this year I'm working at the district. In May, I found out that I was the Salt Lake District Teacher of the Year, and just at the beginning of September, I was named the Utah State 2019 Teacher of the Year. I was interviewed by a reporter after I received my award, and one of the first things she asked was, how did I get to this point? How did I become the Utah State Teacher of the Year? And I let her know that I became the Teacher of the Year kind of not by myself, with the support and collaboration of many other educators. I've worked with some really great teachers and administrators, and most importantly, students. Without students, I would not even be considered, obviously. But I have a special place in my heart for West and for my avid students here at West as well. Even though I'm not at West anymore, the job that I have with the district still allows me to go to a lot of different schools. So if you see me at West, come up and say hi. I miss the students most of all. The energy that students give it's not comparable anywhere else. The district office just does not have that kid energy, and I really miss it.
We were fortunate to have one of our first robotics students elected for the prestigious Dean's List Award, a national honor very few students are awarded.
FIRST Robotics stands for Inspiration and Recognition of Science and Technology. It's the largest robotics high school competition program. And look, I'm wearing a FIRST cape. Yay! So you might have seen our logo. We have a bunch of teams here at West High. The FIRST Dean's List Award is the highest award a student can win in first robotics competition. The award is given to the top students in the entire world. It's a worldwide competition, so it's an extremely prestigious award.
Shreya, we are so happy to be able to present the first Dean's List Award to you. So congratulations, and thank you for representing West so well.
Congrats, Shreya, on your accomplishment. Any student interested in participating in robotics should visit Enrique's room to learn more. Are you going to the dance, but you still don't have an outfit? If so, here's something you might be interested in.
Welcome to the Cinderella's Closet, the place where you can get a free outfit for the dance. We have both ladies and gents outfits like dresses, ties, coats, vests, you name it. The outfits come in all sizes and all colors. All you need to do is show up with your student ID and pick an outfit. Remember, it's free. So come one, come all. For more information, visit room 231, also known as the Family Resource Center.
On Friday, your Panther football team played against the Olympus Titans. The Titans came out flying, scoring 14 points in each of the first three quarters. Although West finished on a high note, scoring 12 points in the fourth quarter, West fought hard but ultimately came up short as the final score for the game was 42-12 Olympus. Last year, we had a great tailgate before the homecoming football game. We talked to Samson, the West Spirit Ambassador.
First of all, it's a homecoming tailgate and it's homecoming week, so of course we want to see you there. But we want to make sure that you're showing up because we have a lot of fun activities. There'll be tacos, we got face paint, we have music, games. So there's a lot of things that get students involved before the game. So the tailgate will be on the south lawn and prone to change. It might be in the driver's ed lot. So I'm pretty sure it's going to be driver's ed lot or south lawn. You'll hear one of those in the announcement. It will be Friday, 5:30 to 6:30, so right before the game. So feel free to come, enjoy, and then go to the game.
This year, the homecoming tailgate will be at 5:30, and there will be 500 free tacos to make sure that you get there before they are all gone. Just so you know, TV West has social media bases that you guys can follow. We have an Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook accounts, so go subscribe to those.
So right now, in an effort to have like a relevant experience for our students who are making our show, we put our work on social media. Because that's basically how the universe works right now. On YouTube, all of our TV West shows go up, and that's important because for a lot of reasons, some students don't see TV West in the morning, either because their teachers don't show it, obviously not you because you're watching it right now, but you know, the other ones. And and some of them can't, like we have people in PE classes or dance classes and things like that, so it lets them see the show long after it's supposed to be aired in the morning. Now, we also have Facebook as well, and that's where we can make people aware of stuff that's kind of happening in the moment. For example, we might make an announcement that our show has gone up or that we'll be doing a live production of one of our assemblies or something like that. And it helps us reach out to the community so that they know what we're doing. Finally, we have an Instagram, which is kind of just more of a fun space to sort of keep our brand of TV West out there so people have an awareness of what we're doing and that we can reach out to the community so that they know we can do news stories on them or feature them and what's happening in the school. If you want to find TV West on YouTube, just search TV West. We are the number one hit when you search for TV West, and it hasn't always been that way because it used to be like some YouTube channel based in Uganda, which might be worth watching, but only after you've seen the most recent TV West. Please subscribe, smash that like button. Go to our YouTube channel right now and subscribe. Click the little notification bell so you get the notification as soon as our episode goes live. If you successfully post a comment on our YouTube videos before Theo does, you will win a prize.
Thanks for watching TV West. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Instagram.
pushing, I'm pulling away from you. I give and you take. You're running, I'm running away from you.